What is good, guys? We are back with Star Meister versus Amfuga. He brings a really cool offensive team. Star brings a really cool offensive team with a Hooper that is most likely banned, a Mega Pinsir. I think defensive Lando is nice on this team to help him. He's kind of weak to Zygarde. Pharaoh is going to be a bit more Spadef to check like Midjourney and Ashgrand. And it's going to be Scarf Lady with Defog and Healing Wish. And the Coco is most likely Z-move. He can just U-turn out turn 1 on the Zygarde here. Amfuga is either going to go into the Tangrowth scouting for potential Z-Twinkle Tackle or Specs Dazzling Gleam, something along those lines. Or he's just going to stay in, potentially going just for T-Arrows or Toxic, expecting the Landorus. He does just switch into Tangrowth. U-turn was obviously a fine play there, like I said. So he can go into Pinsir here, and if he has Stone Edge, he can blow the Zapdos away with SD in the Stone Edge. If he doesn't have Stone Edge, he can just go for Return, find out if the Zapdos is max HP and max speed, which is pretty common at the moment. Most Zapdos run max speed to outspeed Lando and pop them with HPIs, stuff like that. And also, since Zapdos doesn't run max defense anymore, Return actually does a good chunk from Pinsir. He also gets information about the Zapdos set, and if the Zapdos comes out, it's not the end of the world for Star, since he does have a Tapu Koko that come in on Zapdos, on most moves that Zapdos has. So he does just fire off a Return. It is 32, so I assume that it's just max HP. And he's gonna go into either the Ladi or the Koko here. You don't want to risk going to Hooper, because Discharge is, one, it's Electric Terrain boosted, and two, you can potentially get Parrot. Koko is a really good play here, because Koko cannot get paralyzed. You don't want to go onto Lando, obviously that gets buffed by HPI and is slower. So yeah, the only options here in my opinion are either the Ladi or the Koko. So yeah, he's gonna, I assume Amfuga is gonna go for a Discharge here. It is Electric Turn boosted, he doesn't lose much. He gets some nice damage on the Koko, 25. So yeah, Star, Amfuga knows this dies to Z Gigavolt Havoc, the Zapdos most likely. He needs the Zapdos for the Pinsir, so Star knows that and can go for U-turn here. Makes the nice play and going for U-turn. So now he can go into his Landorus. And he can threaten the Zygarde with a potential HPIs, and he can just U-turn again to keep up the momentum. I'm not 100% sure if this is Z-move Lando. Like I said already earlier, it's most likely more defensive, and the Z-move is gonna be on the Koko. So like, there's no point in going for rocks, because if you go for rocks, the Zapdos comes in, the Zapdos gets extra leftovers, and then it defogs anyway. And if you U-turn first, you get momentum, and you get chip, and the Zapdos doesn't get more lefties, and you get your Hooper in. And he has no Hyperspace Fury switch in. He only has one Dark Resist, that is the Greninja, and the Greninja gets completely obliterated by Hyperspace Fury. So he does go in a Greninja, and it's gonna get blown away. It does take 79. So the next time the Hooper comes in, basically it gets a kill, because what is Amfuga gonna switch in? So yeah, Star is just gonna go into Ferrothorn just to scout what Greninja that is. So Amfuga can potentially go, like, he threatens this Hooper with a U-turn, right? So Star is obviously gonna switch out, because like I said, Hooper gets the kill when it comes back in later in the game. So Fuga can potentially go for a spike here, or he can just attack. Like, I don't know his set yet, but it could be Scarf, since his team is kind of slow, but it could also be Ash. Usually when teams only have one water type, most of the time it is Ashgren. When they have a second water type, then it's more likely to be Protean. But it obviously depends on the team. But that is just what I have noticed. Like, most of the time it is, like I said, that this should be. So like, if I go by that logic, it should be Ash. So Star is gonna go Pharaoh here, I assume. He can also go Koko if he's confident, if he predicts a U-turn or a spike. But Ferrothorn overall lives any one hit, and he doesn't really need the Ferrothorn for anything else. The only thing he needs it for would be Alakazam, but he has options for the Zam. He has a Hooper. If that is healthy, it can take any hit from Zam. He has a Pinsir that has quick attack, so he can try to get it in range. He has a Scarf Lady that can kill it with Draco after some prior chips, so he's completely fine. So we do see it as Ashgren that expects damage. Pretty sure this Pharaoh has some Spadef for sure. So now I expect him to go for either a Hazard or a Leech Seed, and Amfuga is either gonna go to Zapdos or the Heatran here. Those are like Amfuga's best switch-ins, Heatran and Zapdos. He does go Heatran, there are the rocks, and I assume Star's play here is most likely it's gonna be the Hooper. If he has some like coverage move on other ones, like, I don't agree with subbing there, because he already showed Hyperspace Fury, and Hyperspace Fury goes through sub, and like, Hooper was a fine play there anyway, because it has really good natural speed death, so it could eat out a Magma Storm. I'm pretty sure that the Hooper didn't show lefties. The Heatran did not show lefties. I'm pretty sure he was the Magma Storm. That set is fire. My man BTB likes to build with that set. It does a lot of damage. And so yeah, I'm already a bit behind here. So he did kill off the Tran with the Hyperspace through the sub. Start looking like he's in a really good position. I don't think he can lose this game. Lando munches that 1000 arrows, goes for HP Ice. He can now just go for U-turn into Pinsir. If this Tangler does not have Rock Slide, he goes for a Protect first, okay. So, I can see his set now. So he's Protect, U-turn, HP Ice, and Earthquake. That's a really cool set, and instead of Rocks, he has Rocks on Pharaoh. And he doesn't have Spikes, which makes a lot of sense, because most of the time, he's gonna be defogging for his Pinsir, so it makes sense that he only has Rocks and not Spikes on top of that. And Protect can help him a lot, so his Landorus stays healthy to check Zygarde. And yeah, amazing, nice U-turn into the Pinsir, got the kill on the Tangrowth. It was pretty obvious that the Tangrowth most likely is not Rock Slide on Amfuga's team, as he's gonna Roost here, obviously, to keep it healthy. I expect Starmer just go for the Gigavolt here. But yeah, like, Tangrowth sometimes carries Rock Slide if a team is weak to Volk and to Zard-Y, but his team has like good checks in Heatran and Zygarde to both of these ones, so I completely understand the U-turn play from Starheart into Pinsir, because they can eat up HP Ice and then go for Frustration, get the kill. So now he got in the Zygarde on the Gigavolt, but like, Star is still in such a good position. He can just fire off HP Ice here, like, he's already so far ahead. And now he can go for Earthquake or U-turn, because Zygarde is not a problem, and if he switches into Alakazam or Zapdos, both could take HP Ice with ease. Then, like, if Fuga makes that switch, then he gets momentum, he gets his Hooper in, and he just gets a kill. Unless he gets Discharge Parrot, Full Parrot. He does not get Full Parrot, he picks up the Zapdos with the Choice Bandit Hyperspace Fury, and Greninja, I assume, can kill it with a Hydro Pump from here. It is back, so like, I didn't run the Kulk, but I assume Hydro Pump most likely kills. Star can still keep this around. If Alakazam doesn't have Dazzling Gleam, Hooper can still live a hit from Alakazam. He goes just into Pharaoh to scout. I mean, that was a completely fine play. If he goes for Dark Pulse there, I don't remember, like, if he goes for Dark Pulse, I think then he could have just pivoted back into the Coco. I think the Coco was healthy enough to be pivoted into on a Dark Pulse. And if you just went for Pump or Spikes, then the Pharaoh is completely fine there. So now Amfuga has to go first into Zygarde to weaken the Pharaoh Thorn, because a Focus Blast or HP Fire, one of the two moves, is going to be the coverage that Alakazam is going to be packing. They don't kill from this range, so he has to weaken the Pharaoh first. But yeah, the game is pretty much over at this point. He has a Scarf Lari, he has Quick Attack from Pinsir. Hooper can also live a hit unless the Zem has Dazzling Gleam. And even if the Zem has Dazzling Gleam, Quick Attack plus Scarf Lari should win the game for Star. So he does show Hidden Power Fire, so he doesn't have to risk Focus Blast missing. That's pretty cool for Fuga. There's the Hooper, so now he wants to see if he has Dazzling Gleam. There's the Dazzling Gleam, so Hooper dies. But now he can go Pinsir and click Quick Attack, weaken the Alakazam, die to the Psychic, I assume. As he also, that was funny, Iron Bob's Alakazam. Yeah, that's the Psychic, and Scarf Lari can just click Psyshock or Psychic or whatever. Alakazam is really bad defense, so obviously he had killed. Thank you guys for watching, this was a really quick game, and yeah, I enjoyed it a lot. The first game Star played, he brought like a Feather team with Ducky. Ducky is not allowed anymore. But yeah, he can play like a lot of styles. I'm not saying that he only uses Fed. This was like really fire to watch. Thank you guys for watching. Nice win. And the only play that was like not that good in this game was the sub play. But yeah, Fuga is also good. He just had like bad matchup, I feel. And he got overwhelmed. Thank you guys for watching, and goodbye.